Well, Martin, you've knocked out the number one seed for the tournament tonight, and a very good performance from you, especially from 2-1 down.
Yeah, I'm delighted. It was a little bit scrappy, and I think we both kind of got bogged down to start off with. I think that the century made to go 2-1 up kind of kick-started me more than anything. It kind of told me up the tempo, speed up a little bit, get a nice rhythm and pace about me around the table. Otherwise, I probably would have just kept doing what, playing at pedestrian pace, shall we say. That's not my standard. I like to get on with it, and I always tell myself to keep a flow going, so get a nice pace around the table. So that's why I sort of 2-2, I left the arena, said to myself, right, up the tempo and see what he's got, if he can answer, basically.
It's been a strange few days for you, because you had a good run in the Betvictor Scottish Open last week, last 16. Even after that, you weren't sure whether you were going to be in this event. What was that? What was kind of going through your mind as you watched, particularly Ronnie O'Sullivan's game against Li Hang, not knowing whether you were going to be in this week or not?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I didn't watch any of that Ronnie Li Hang game. I was still on my way home when that was going on. It's obviously a long journey from Clondidno. So I got home sort of about 3:30-ish. I literally unpacked, stuck all the washing on, made something, a cup of tea, something to eat. And then a mate of mine texted me, said, "You're in." And that's how I knew. But Suzanne had alerted me anyway from World Snooker that morning, because they wanted to know if I would be willing enough to be standby if I didn't get in outright. So I said, yeah, no problem if that was the case. So I still would have been in the building at some point this week, but whether I'd have played or not is another matter. But yeah, it's nice of Ronnie. I'll have to treat him to some dinner at some point next time we have a game. So
good person to be rooting for. But now you're in the event and you've obviously won a match now. Do you feel you're on a bit of a free roll, because you might not have been in it in any case?
I felt as if I was probably on a free roll anyway. The other thing is I've just sort of the last week playing with a new cue as well, so there's little aspects of that are still catching me out. But I feel very comfortable with it. It's a little bit different to what I'm used to, but I'm enjoying playing with it, and I'm enjoying the new challenge of playing with something different. I've played with the same thing for 25 years, so it's like a part of my right arm has gone wandering, but that part is now starting to slowly, very slowly, but nice and nicely getting back into position. So I mean, as I say, it's nice that I've kind of won a few matches with a brand new wand. I didn't expect anything last week. I nearly even pulled out, because my cue went, my old cue went on me the day before coming. So I did contemplate pulling out, because I thought to myself, there's no way I've got enough time to get used to playing with this cue and then going 5-hour journey to Clondidno to play a match that I wasn't sure whether I'd do any good. But I'm kind of glad I did go in the end.
And over the years, we've seen some fantastic performances from you. You've won some great tournaments, big tournaments. Your ceiling as a player is probably as high as a lot of the other top players. Do you feel that you're close now to that sort of form where you could win another big tournament again?
I've always felt as if I'm close. It's just it's just one of those where you just need one of those weeks where everything clicks. I've been close a couple of times in the last couple of years, lost a couple of finals 9-8 and stuff like that. So I know there's always the doors slightly ajar. It's just a matter of having that one week where I just push it wide open and pick up a trophy. But it could be this week, you never know.
Well done tonight, Martin.
Cheers.